ski performance breakthrough. Priority number 3. Pivot-based steering. There are only 3 factors that influence the behavior of your skis in the snow. Each of these factors is called a steering element, and if you blend them skillfully, you will be able to steer your skis effectively in all circumstances. The 3 steering elements are the pressure between the ski and the snow, tilting the edge of the ski into the snow, and pivoting or rotating the ski. Let's start by simplifying everything and identifying 2 specific approaches to steering, each of which gives you a different family of curves that you can create. Each of these approaches is suited to a particular set of circumstances. By understanding these processes and learning how to apply them, you can become much more effective in different types of terrain around the mountain. Each of these approaches uses all 3 steering elements, of course, but each uses a different element as its main ingredient. The 2 approaches are pivot-based steering and pressure-based steering. And this session deals with pivot-based steering. With pivot-based steering, the main ingredient is a healthy dose of pivoting or rotation of the skis, plus some edging to ensure effective grip and the use of the ski's design. The pressure develops naturally throughout the curve because of the other inputs. This approach is very effective for controlling your speed. I'm going to introduce this idea so that it's suitable for intermediate skiers, and then I'm going to develop it for you so that advanced skiers and experts can take advantage of this approach. If you stand on one ski and pick up the other, you can pivot your foot so that your toes, and so your ski, point to the left and then to the right. It's a very natural, simple movement, as are most skiing movements. Just making this movement 3 or 4 times with each foot is enough to make your body more aware of the pivoting movement, allowing you to have easier access to it when you set off on your skis. If you slide forwards on a gentle slope with good balance, you can gently pivot your right ski to the left across your body and tilt it gently onto its inside edge so that it begins to grip the snow. This produces skidding, which is a scraping action of the ski's edge across the snow. But please do not assume that this approach is for beginners only. If you really want to ski safely and effectively in steep terrain such as red runs, black runs, bump fields, and beautiful powder off-piste slopes, then you need to stay with me here as I develop this process for you. You can pivot with both feet in the same direction if you have the balance, coordination, and experience. This will produce a skidded parallel turn if you pivot them both at the same time, at the same rate, and by the same amount. So already, we are adding some specific qualities to the coordination of this movement, to allow intermediate and advanced skiers to use this process for their parallel skiing. Let's take a closer look at the coordination of this type of steering for parallel skiers. As you begin to pivot both feet, you can also begin to tilt your skis gently onto their edges. Straight away, the design of the ski will begin to work for you and you will create a curve. Keep both movements developing gently and progressively until you decide that the curve has completed its work for you. You can repeat this in the other direction, and there you have it, linked, skidded, parallel turns. There is a specific moment which offers you the best time to begin this pivoting movement. You discovered this movement as you worked with your priority number 2, the edge changing process. Yes, that's right, begin pivoting as your skis become flat in the snow. The more accurate you are with your timing of this, the better your steering results will be. Pivot-based steering is a versatile steering method that is essential for all skiers. There are different intensities of skidding, and it's a good thing to develop your performance so that you can skid gently or firmly while producing curves of different sizes. You can manage this by blending the elements in different amounts. For example, a little pivoting plus a little edging is likely to produce longer, gently skidded curves. These are very effective at helping you to ski smoothly on reasonably gentle terrain. A lot of pivoting, produced by a larger range of movement and a faster rate of movement, can combine with a lot of edging to produce shorter, firmly skidded curves. These curves are very effective at controlling your speed on steep slopes. But because your steering inputs are larger, your coordination and accuracy have to be good if you're to avoid throwing yourself out of balance. More advanced skiers will be able to use the latter approach for effectiveness on steep slopes and in bump fields. Developing control of pivoting and edging allows you to deal with some very complex environments. Improving your accuracy and consistency, as well as versatility with these actions, is part of that development. So your body needs the opportunity to practice and develop the balance, movement, and coordination that makes this possible. In summary, pivoting at the beginning of the curve, and continuing to do so throughout the arc, combined with good edge control, can give you a family of curves that skid, control your speed, and help you to stay safe on steeper ground. Timing your movements to take advantage of the moment when the skis become flat in the snow transforms the quality of this steering. So now you have a very accurate steering method, plus an excellent process that helps you to improve the quality with which you use it. Use our program of 6 drills to help you to develop this ability and groove it into your performance. Before you ski each drill, please listen to the music that's been specially created to help you become relaxed and alert. This will really help you to learn more quickly and to ski more effectively. As you listen to the music, please smile. When you smile, your pineal gland releases serotonin, which makes you feel good and enhances the quality of your performance. Please remember to begin on a simple blue run and use each drill a few times before progressing to the next. Give your body the opportunity it needs to change. Once you have skied a few times through all 6 drills, you will find that your pivot-based steering will give you excellent control and you can move on to priority number 4.